Hey, yes, welcome to the channel. We react a little differently around here in different films, different format. Hope you like it. Today, we are finishing with the first season of After Forever, starring Kevin Spirtas, Mitchell Anderson, and Cady Huffman. So, let's put our feet up and watch episode 5 of After Forever.
What would you want to be remembered for?
Discovering one of the authors I represent.
Ah. Art's important. It's what survives.
Tell that to ISIS. Or to the Republicans.
Is there a difference?
Nope.
Making me breakfast. You've come a long way.
Well, every other time you either didn't want to stay over or you bolted first thing in the morning.
Because they were work days.
And the possibility of violence?
You know, I love just about all his work, but this piece...
Oh, if I had to explain Alvarez with one word, this would be it.
Exactly. You bought it?
No, I wanted to, but it was already sold.
He could steal it.
Sneak it out of here. Split custody of it, 6 months apiece.
I don't think it'll fit under either one of our jackets.
I knew I should have worn an overcoat.
Yeah, a very large overcoat.
Like from before I lost the 350 pounds?
Yeah, I love that poster. I know the artist.
Yeah.
I mean... I don't know him, he's dead. I know his work.
Happy anniversary.
Dinner at Jean-Georges was supposed to be a gift for each other.
I know, but this is sort of for both of us, too.
Oh, no.
Remember?
The night we met? Okay, Riley, bedtime.
Oh.
Bummer.
But I want to have dinner with you guys.
You already had your dinner.
But I want to sit with you.
We already had this conversation.
What did we tell you?
That it's a grown-up dinner.
Exactly.
But it's just you guys and Brian.
Bed. Now.
Brian.
Oh, no. You need to bed. He's nice.
What's he do?
I'm not exactly sure.
Not exactly sure, like, he might be a drug dealer or a hitman?
No. I'm not exactly sure. Because we really haven't talked that much. Oh, God. The sex is great.
What's changing our lives is that after 7 months of renovation that our architect and contractor said would take 4 or 5 at the most, we finally moved into our new home today.
In the long run, you'll forget all about the extra couple of months. Hmm. Maybe we could.
Don't even think about it. But your place is gorgeous.
Thanks. List the apartment with them now since a decent amount of time had passed.
You're kidding.
They start coming 1 or 2 weeks after Jason died. Only the first ones didn't say a decent amount of time had passed.
What do they do, scour the obituaries?
Yes.
Probably.
So, are you thinking of moving?
No.
How about redoing the place? Making it more yours? Singular.
I don't know.
Look at all the magnets on the door. It's funny. You know they have kids.
So, you never really liked the fabric we chose for the sofa? Or the color we chose for these walls?
That was all you, babe.
You'll always be my forever.
Well, that was episode 5. I mean, I know it's tough to lose someone, but I don't know if still holding on so tight after, you know, more than a year or so, is that healthy? I don't know. I can't say I've never lost someone like that. So. Well, let's see what episode 6 brings.
Is it cheating if it's just jerking off together?
No.
How about if it's jerking each other off?
Depends if there's kissing involved. And on location. Neutral territory, definitely not. Hmm. One of the other's home, maybe. And definitely if there's kissing.
I read a piece by a woman who considered herself a bigamist because after being widowed, she remarried. But she still loved her first husband.
We met online.
I had only been in this country 2 weeks.
I keep telling you we need to set you up for a profile.
No, Brian doesn't need to go online. He's already met someone, Paul.
You didn't tell your work wife?
I was going to.
His name is Ron.
They met one weekend when he was bicycling with Riley,
our son.
Riley said Ron was totally into Brian. And apparently now Ron even has a last name.
What do you mean?
Brian said he couldn't fuck him because he didn't know his last name.
Are you fucking him or dating him? Because if you're dating him, where is he?
I asked him if he was free, and he said he had plans.
Well, did you tell him we were coming to this incredibly cool new place and that he was going to get to meet a sometimes Broadway star?
Oh, the humility of a performer.
I asked him if he was available tonight, and he said he wasn't.
Where's he going?
Somebody hot?
Brian.
Hey. What are you doing here?
Oh, I
knew it. Never mind. Meet my friends.
Come on.
They
won't he's there with someone else.
Everybody, this is Ron. Ron, this is everybody.
Hi.
Did I mention you were coming there?
No. It's Jeff.
I thought we were going to
have see, I told you.
Jeff, this is everybody. Everybody, this is Jeff, my partner.
Partner?
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah, 3 years. Yeah.
3 years.
Yeah, he travels a lot for work.
Yeah.
I'll bet.
Brian. How do you and Ron know each other?
I've been fucking him while you were in China.
Ooh!
3 years.
He has a partner for 3 years and doesn't feel the need to mention it. You know, it's not like we were just hooking up. We were dating. You know what? There's not going to be a next time. No. I've got my friends. I've got the memory of Jason. I don't need another relationship. I can have sex whenever I want, and we'll leave it at that.
I don't care if they had an open relationship. What I care is that the fucker didn't let me in what was going on. He let me on.
Yeah, that's not cool.
Me.
Would you have slept with him if he told you about Jeff?
Fuck no. Okay. Once, maybe. Tops. Twice. That's what it would have.
It just made me feel like I could have a life after Jason.
You will have a life after Jason.
Not with Ron.
But with someone. Your friends will make sure of it.
I don't want you to. I just need your support.
This is me.
Yeah. Sorry I screwed up your night with Sophia.
She's supportive. We lesbians are very empathetic. Besides, she's coming over later.
Do you know how fucking sexy you are?
Hey. No.
What?
We've got to get downstairs.
I'm not scared.
The wedding's about to
start.
Take
this off.
No. What are you doing?
Kiss me. Mm-hmm.
Oh. Ron's an asshole. Keep going.
Thanks.
Hey, Brian. Kissing off frogs, right? That's one frog down.
Well, that was episode 6. That took a turn that I was not expecting. Oh. Okay. Let's see where it keeps going. Episode 7.
We weren't sure what it would feel like being here for the first time since...
Since the funeral.
And I keep expecting Jason to just walk in from somewhere.
Here we go!
We were just telling Brian how much we love what you did with this apartment. Mm-hmm. It's even more beautiful than the photos.
It's like delicious.
Oh, okay. You haven't changed a thing.
Yeah, I like it this way.
I don't think I could. Are you dating anyone?
No.
Why not? It's been over a year. You're handsome, you're successful. It's what Jason would want. It's what we want.
I just haven't met anyone.
Sound a little weird. We are your in-laws.
Well, this new couple moved in next door to us, and we've gotten kind of friendly with them.
Yes, and their son, who lives right here in New York, and he just broke up with his boyfriend.
Really?
And I've seen photos of this guy, David. He's very good looking. And we've told his parents about you and Jason. And, well, I have his phone number.
Jason's parents are trying to set you up.
That is so sweet.
It's not sweet. It's creepy.
It is sweet in a creepy way.
It's sweet.
They just want you to be happy.
He's watching out for her. Lisa's been making lists.
I haven't been making lists. I've just been thinking about who I know. And as well-meaning as they are, older people are not the ones you want setting you up. So I think I have found the perfect guy. Mm-hmm. He's an actor, a real actor, not a waiter actor, and I am texting you his information.
Trust me, I love Lisa and Andrew, but you don't want straight people setting you up.
She's right.
So, I didn't want to bring it up yet. And after that fiasco with Ron, and since you still don't want to do the online thing, I have someone in mind for my work husband. I'll send you his info.
You're letting a lesbian set you up? How would a lesbian know what's happening to a man?
Paul's right. If you were straight and she was trying to fix you up with a woman, maybe.
I get it.
I mean, after that fiasco with Ron, if you're ready to be set up...
I'm not ready to be set up.
You're a waiter from brunch.
Travis.
He's 21 years old. He's into older guys. And he's hot. Did you notice his ass? And some of the other waiters told us he's incredibly well. They all change into their uniforms together.
Listen to you guys.
I mean, if I didn't have to worry about a workplace sexual harassment lawsuit if we fired him, I'd do him.
We'd both do him.
I said I would give you his number.
Paul, just say thank you and report back with details. 21-year-old waiter is not what you need.
Oh, especially after the fiasco with Ron.
Well, I wasn't going to bring it up, but... I was at a closing the other day, and the seller's attorney and I got to talking, and... Mm-hmm. He's smart, successful, age-appropriate, single. Text me his number.
So, when are they going to start the chemo?
Not gonna.
I'm not doing the chemo.
What, are they just starting with radiation?
I'm not doing the chemo, I'm not doing the radiation, I'm not doing any of it. I'm gonna die whether I have the chemo and the radiation or not. Brian and I have talked about it. A lot. I'm not gonna have him put me through hell for the possibility that it might buy me another few excruciating weeks.
I gave birth to one son and I wound up with two. And now I'm back to one. But if you ever get
married. When you get married again, I expect, we expect to be there.
Okay. Okay, okay, okay.
Oh, come here.
I love you.
I love you.
Promise me you'll watch over my parents after I'm gone.
Honey, will you stop worrying about everybody else and start worrying about yourself, please?
I'm serious. They're gonna need you. Promise me.
Promise.
But Brian, he's gonna need help. Promise me you'll watch over him.
We promise.
And Mom, you can't ever let him know it's because I asked you to.
Whoa. Episode 7 packed a lot of emotion into those 12 minutes, yeah. Oh. Okay, on we go. Number 8.
Put your very good food in your very good Tupperware. Put your very good Tupperware in your very good fridge and get your very good ass down here.
No, I've got a meeting with a huge prospective client in the morning and I need to prep for it.
Who?
I can't say.
How huge? How huge is what?
Brian's prospective new client.
Who is it?
He won't say.
Just come down and have dinner. I'll sit you in his station, and I guarantee he'll provide the dessert.
I told you, I've got to prepare for my meeting.
Fine, fine. Break the boy's heart. Maybe turn him off of older men forever.
I'm hanging up now. Bye.
Paul, I told you, I've got work to do.
This isn't Paul.
What? God, I'm sorry.
It's David Taylor. Is this Brian?
Yeah, a friend of mine has been calling and calling and wanted me to join him for dinner. I thought it was him again.
Is this a bad time?
No, I'm sorry. Do I know you?
So look, I realize this is pretty weird, and trust me, I don't make a habit of letting my parents try to fix me up.
I'm not judging you.
Try Facebook.
Actually, I think they took my breakup harder than either of us did. They really liked my ex, and I think they've always been more comfortable with me being gay when I'm in a relationship. Yeah, that part they understand.
Right. Right.
Anyone who manages to have no photos of themselves online is hiding something.
So look, I know my parents and your in-laws meant well, but I don't want you to feel on the spot here. They told me you lost your husband.
Just a little over a year ago.
You do come highly recommended from people I love.
So do you. Of course, the people I love have never met you, and the people you love have never met me.
Uh-oh. Maybe I should rethink a sight unseen dinner.
I promise I am not a serial killer.
Okay, wait a minute. Hold on. That never even entered my mind. Now I'm worried.
And now, you're not going to have any more pain.
It's okay, baby. It's gonna be just like you wanted.
I've got a favorite restaurant. Let me see if I can get us a reservation. I'll email you.
Sounds good.
I'm looking forward to this.
Me too.
Ha ha.
drinks.
Too late now.
Did you think that guy was me?
Okay, look, I didn't have a clue as to what you looked like.
There's not a photo anywhere online, do you know that?
I mean, there's nothing on LinkedIn, nothing on Facebook.
Well, years ago I had a stalker and it spooked me, so I tried to keep my photo presence as discreet as possible. But you looked.
Oh yeah, didn't you?
Oh yeah, before I even made the call.
Well, that was After Forever. That was really good. I actually liked that they were able to cram so much story into such short episodes. I mean, each one was only like 10 minutes long, but I think the economy with which they told the story was like one of the highlights. I mean, wow, 10 minutes and you feel like you really, really know these characters, these people. Well done. I'm hoping season 2 is just as good. I will probably not wait too long to watch that because, like I said, they're shorter. And I really do want to see where this is going. So I will probably watch that one in the next few weeks and then get that post probably up sometime in like June. But until the next time we put our read up, laters.